Good day, second year students. So far, we have completed 3 essays prescribed in your syllabus for paper first. For your remembrance, I repeat the title of the essays: Of Friendship by Francis Bacon, Of Myself by Abraham Kuyper, and The Spider and the Bee by Jonathan Swift. All these 3 essays we have covered in the previous classes. Today we are going to briefly discuss another essayist, and the name of the essayist is Joseph Addison. His essay, The Spectator's Account of Himself, is prescribed in your course for detailed study. But before we take up the essay, let us know briefly about Joseph Addison, and then we will move on to study his essay. So to begin with, first, let us have an overview of his life and his career as an author. An English essayist, poet, and playwright, and a politician, Joseph Addison was born on 1672. He was educated at Charterhouse School in London, and there he first met Richard Steele. You might have heard the name Richard Steele, as Steele's essay, if you remember, was prescribed in your first year course. And these two names, Steele and Addison, are often taken together because of their long association in the contribution of the development of English prose. In the year 1687, Addison attended Queen's College at Oxford, where he did well and achieved distinction in the study of classics, and as a result, he studied at Magdalen College. His first major literary work was An Account of the Greatest English Poets in 1694. During this period, he published several Latin poems. He also took an active interest in politics, and between 1699 to 1703, he toured the continent and met many political leaders and diplomats. In 1705, he wrote a poem entitled The Campaign, and this poem was a celebration of the recent victory of allied forces of Britain over France in the Battle of Blenheim, and as a reward, this poem secured him the position of Commissioner of Appeals and finally Secretary of State under the ruling Whig government. In 1708, his political career reached its zenith, reached its height, when he became Member of Parliament. The year 1709 was the most productive phase of his life. This was the time when his true genius as a writer came out with the publication of periodical essays. Now, what is periodical essay? So this form of writing was much popular in the 18th century England, and these essays were used to publish in a magazine or a journal, usually 2 or 3 times a week, and they were often narrated by a person or a group of person, commonly referred to as a club. Joseph Addison and Steele were the 2 main contributors in the development of these periodical essays, and their joint publication, The Tatler and The Spectator, in the year 1709 and in the year 1711 respectively. So these 2 publications was very much popular among the readers. He was also a playwright, and his one famous tragedy, Cato, was performed in 1713. He died in the year 1719 at the young age of 47, and he was buried at Westminster Abbey. Now let's talk about his prose style. Addison's evaluation as a prose writer is summed up beautifully in a quote which says, "Whoever wishes to attain an English style, familiar but not coarse, elegant but not ostentatious, must give his days and nights to the volumes of Addison." And this quote is by Dr. Samuel Johnson. And Dr. Samuel Johnson is a famous 18th century critic and scholar. And if we discuss his style with reference to this, to Dr. Johnson's words, it comes out that his style is familiar. Familiar means written in simple conversational style, but it is not coarse. Though written in simple language, it is not coarse, it is not vulgar. It is elegant, but not ostentatious. Ostentatious means it means showy or fancy. So there is no pretension in the style of Addison. And there is a perfect balance. And Dr. Johnson also considered his style as the model of the middle style, a natural and simple style that suited for his subject matters. Now let us know briefly about the essay that we will be studying in our further classes, The Spectator's Account of Himself. So this essay, The Spectator's Account of Himself, is the first paper of his periodical The Spectator. And as the title suggests, here Addison gives an account, a portrait of the narrator, namely Mr. Spectator, who is actually the voice of the author. And Mr. Spectator introduces himself in the essay by saying, "Thus I live in the world rather as a spectator of mankind than as one of species, by which means I have made myself a speculative statesman, soldier, merchant, and artisan without ever meddling with any practical parts in life." So this Mr. Spectator is a kind of detached observer, an onlooker of the life and people around him. We shall discuss this essay in detail in the next class. So this much for today's class. Thank you.